Hi dear students, myself Deepak Mori and today I am going to teach you mathematics of standard 7, lesson number 21 and name of the lesson is data handling. So as we are knowing that in our day-to-day life, many persons are handling with the data as a numbers, as a collection of many numbers and many more. So the collection of many numbers together that are same or not same, that collection is nothing but a data. So we will learn about it in detail. So what is meant by data? Statistics is a science which deals with analyze, collection, presentation and interpretation of numerical figures. This interpretation is nothing but a data. So we will define it. So data, a collection of numerical figure giving some specific information about the performance of 20 students as given below is called as a data. It means that a collection of numerical figures which is giving a suitable information of any suitable data, that is nothing but a data. We will take an example. There are 20 students from a class who scored out of 100. Then that students are 55, 65, 25, 40, 35, 70, 90, 92, 84, 85, 70, 75, 65, 72, 80, 78, 64, 88, 76. These marks are got to the 20 students out of 100. So this particular data which is collected of 20 students who got out of 100 marks, that is nothing but a data. And the data which is given in a numerical figures, which is nothing but an observation. So it's 55, 65, 20, 40, 35, 70, 90, 92, 84, 85, etc. These numbers are nothing but observations, which are observed by us who got out of 100 marks. 20 students got, and that 20 students got the marks of 55, 65, 20, 40. This is nothing but an observation. That is why the numbers which are given in the data, that are nothing but an observation. Now there are two types of data, primary data and secondary data. We will move to that. As we are going to learn the next topic of the lesson, that is primary data and secondary data. These are the two types of data. So what is meant by primary data? A primary data is a data collected by a person directly without taking the help of any source for a specific purpose. It is a data which is collected directly by a person without taking any help of another source. For example, if a teacher wants to observe our students, then whenever the teacher is teaching to the students, that time the observation did by the teacher, this is nothing but a primary data, directly observation. Now the second one is nothing but a secondary data. These are the data borrowed by a person from some other source to be used further. A secondary data means a data which is took by a person from another source that is already used by another person. That is nothing but a secondary data. For example, a principal asks to the teacher about the students, what is the capability or what is the observation you have done in the class. Then that is nothing but an example of a secondary data. In that example, a principal is asking to the teacher, and teacher already did the observation of the students. That is why that is nothing but an example of a secondary data. Now the collected data. Now the collected data in its original form is called as a raw data. Means whatever the data which is collected in the original form, that we can able to say that a raw data. Okay, this was there about the primary and secondary data. Now a particular data we can able to arrange in ascending order and descending order. As we know that ascending order and descending order how to arrange. If a particular data is having the same numbers, then we have to repeat that same numbers, and by using that we have to arrange it ascending and descending order. And the data which is arranged in ascending or descending order, that we can able to say that array or arrayed data. Now the next topic of the lesson is tabulation of data. Now how to tabulate a data? We will learn it. Now we will start with the tabulation of data. Now, as a tabulation of data means what? Whatever the observation or whatever the raw data we have, that we have to arrange in a systematic form, in the form of a table. That is nothing but a tabulation of data. Arranging a data in a systematic repeated. For that we are using tally marks, and the frequency is nothing but how many times that number, same numbers are repeated. It means that how many lines will be here, that many line, that same number will be in the numerical forms. So let in a first family there are four members. So how many times the four members are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The five families are there, in that four family members are there. So number of members are four. How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five families, and frequency is nothing but 5. Okay, number of members are four in a how many families? We got it from this particular data. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. There are five families were there that are having four members in the family. That is why number of members 4. How many families were there? By using the tally marks, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this line is showing that 5 completed. And frequency is nothing but 5 families were there that are having the four family members. Now as 4, 4, 4, 4, and this 4 over. Now let's leave to the 4. Now the next number is 5. So how many families is having 5 members in that family? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then there are 6 families which are having the 5 family members. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and here also 6. As 5 or now the next number 6. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, in a 4 families, there are 6 number of members are there. Though 1, 2, 3, 4, and here 4. 6 members in a families. There are 4 families which are having the 6 number of members in the family. That is here 4. Now, as 6 or now the next number 7. 1, 2, 3, over. So, in another 3 families, there are 7 members. So that is a 1, 2, 3, and here 3. And now the last number which is remaining here, 8, 1, and 2. There are 8 members in only 2 families. That is here 2 lines, and here 2. This is nothing but a tabulation of data. And this particular tabulated data we are knowing as a frequency distribution table. We are knowing as a frequency distribution table. And this is how we can able to tabulate on any raw data which is given to us in a tabulation of data or frequency distribution table. Now, the next topic of the lesson is mean. So what is mean by mean? A mean is a calculation of observations. If number of observations are 6, then the total sum of all the 6 observations divided by a number of observations. This is nothing but a mean. And whenever the mean we are getting, that it is not necessary that the mean should be always a number of observations. It should be from an observations. It will be out of the observations also. So how to find out the mean? There is a formula to find out a mean. A mean is equals to sum of all observations divided by number of observations. So let me take an example. For example, if there are numbers 5, 6, 8, 10, 12 and 40, then these are the given observations to us. So as by using the formula, the mean is equals to sum of all observations upon number of observations. So let we will find first of all one by one. So let by putting the values in this given formula, so sum of all the observations, which means that 5 plus 6 plus 8 plus 10 plus 12 plus 14 divided by number of observations. So how many number of observations are there? 1 2 3 4 5 6. There are 6 number of observations. Now first of all do the sum and then divide by this 6. So let do the sum. 6 plus 5 11, 11 plus 8 19, 19 plus 10 29, 29 plus 12 31, 31 plus 14 55. So 55 divided by 6. Now divide it. So whatever the answer we will get, it is not necessary that answer will be from this particular observations. Okay, so divide it. 6 ones are 6, 6 8s are 48 point. Though after dividing, the answer will be 8.11. So as the mean we got 8.11, then the 8.11 is not a number which is from this observations. It is near about that particular observation. Here 8 is given, that is a 8.11. It is a near about values, but it is not exactly that same values. It is not necessary that the number should be from the given observations for the mean. So this is how we can able to find out a mean. So the next topic, a properties of mean, we will learn in the next video. This is for today. Have a good day. Bye dear students.